I've been studying the intersection of labor and international economics for the vast majority of my career, almost 20 years now. So one of the first stages in the path of development that we have seen many countries follow for the last 100 years has been to begin their development process by producing apparel products. As the developing countries become more engaged in the global economy, people have become increasingly concerned about the conditions in which these workers are working. The conditions are often described as sweatshops, where workers are working in very long hours, they have very high temperatures, they have very unfavorable conditions in terms of water and sanitation. The workers are primarily women. They're generally a little bit younger. The current structure of the global apparel trade involves many stakeholders. International buyers design products and bring them to market. The producers in the developing countries are our second stakeholder. The third group is the workers themselves, who work often with very long hours in order to produce these products. The fourth main stakeholder, of course, is the governments and the international policy community. All the stakeholders, we would argue, have some stake in improving the working conditions in the factories, but they also would like to see improvements in the performance of the factories as well. In the past, people have tried to address the concerns about workers in a confrontational way by pitting the producers against the workers or pitting the buyers against the governments. One of the innovations of this Better Work program in particular is to try and find common ground where all of the stakeholders can understand and build upon their common values and their common goals in order to improve the working conditions of these workers. The very first step of Better Work is the assessment stage. The Better Work program trains local monitors to go into the factories on unannounced visits in order to do an assessment of the working conditions within the factories. One of the goals of the Better Work program is to bring the factories into compliance not only with national laws, but also with international labor standards.
They teach us some many things with Better Work. They told us that we have to learn about labor law, things like discrimination. We don't have allowed this in our factory.
So over time, we have seen an improvement in the direction of compliance with international labor standards as well as the national laws.
Chúng tôi có 2.500 lao động, trong đó có 1.700 công nhân lao động nữ. Nhà máy chúng tôi có nhận được, có tham gia ba cái lớp tập huấn từ Better Work. Thứ nhất là tập huấn hợp tác nơi làm việc, thứ hai là an toàn lao động và thứ ba là thương lượng tập thể. Tuyên truyền liên tục với công nhân về việc sử dụng bảo hộ lao động.
Bảo hiểm bây giờ tốt hơn ngày xưa nhiều, phát bảo hiểm kim, bảo hiểm mắt, bảo hiểm cá nhân cho công nhân và tốt hơn ngày xưa, lao động tai nạn cũng ít hơn.
So one of the other aspects of the Better Work program has been the formulation of these performance improvement consultative committees, which are worker management committees in which they help resolve disputes within the factory and also try and improve performance of the factory in a collaborative way. One of the things that we're seeing is that workers place a very significant value on their relationships with their supervisors.
Since BetterWork, I was the one of the members of PICC in my factory, I was feeling comfortable, confidence, because we have a meeting with the management, we discuss some problems, we can see we achieve.
Công nhân với trường trưởng rất là hòa hợp, ăn ý trong công việc. Dạ mà những gì công nhân không hiểu, trường trưởng sẽ bày vẽ tận tình hơn. Quản lý với công nhân trao đổi trực tiếp trong công việc rất là dễ dàng hơn.
We have seen sustained improvements in the working conditions across almost every dimension throughout the Better Work factories. And this has really been important for improving the living standards of the workers in these factories. So one of the big hesitations of the businesses for improving the working conditions is this initial investment. One of the things that we have learned and that we're seeing throughout the world is that these types of improvements in working conditions can actually contribute to factory performance.
Nhờ vào chương trình Better Work, cải thiện được môi trường làm việc, người lao động gắn bó với nhà máy lâu hơn, giúp cho nhà máy giảm được cái tỷ lệ biến động nhân sự thấp nhất.
One of the other things we're seeing is that as communication improves, workers and the management are better able to resolve disputes, and therefore they're able to improve the performance of the factories.
Nhờ vào chương trình Better Work, nhà máy không có biến động nhân sự, từ đó giúp cho nhà máy nâng cao được năng suất, nâng cao được chất lượng và có thêm nhiều khách hàng mới.
People who are working in the factories are gaining lessons from the Better Work experience and the training, and they're taking those lessons back home, improving the lives of their families as well within the homes. And this turns out to be a rather unexpected but quite pleasant benefit of the Better Work program.
Từ khi công việc của em tốt hơn thì em dành dụm được mua được cái TV mới nè. Dạ, gần đây 2 năm gần đây lương công nhân rất là khá. Trong chi hoạt hàng tháng, còn như em sẽ dùng để cho con ăn học. Vợ chồng em sống rất hòa thuận. Khi vô công ty đây làm, em với chồng em bàn bạc nhau rất kỹ. Làm lương ổn định, về gia đình cũng thoải mái hơn, chi tiêu cũng thoải mái trong cuộc sống. Về con cái, ăn học rồi cũng đầy đủ hơn.
I was the one who attended workshop with BetterWork. They teach us some training with budget, and really I realized that how to manage my salary. I have some improvements because I have a small business at my home. I have some small pigs. Before BetterWork, it was too difficult, but now I have some improvement in my home. I think things will be okay.
Moving forward, we see that there's still obviously room for improvement, as there is in every program. No one is claiming that Better Work is the panacea for all of the problems in developing countries. But one of the things that we are seeing now is that it is definitely a step forward, and there have definitely been improvements over what the situation had been before. It's been a big win, of course, for the workers themselves, it almost goes without saying, because now their working conditions are improving directly. It's been a win for the factory managers as well. These improvements are actually increasing factory performance. Exports have actually increased for countries that are participating in the Better Work program. That's a big win for governments. And then finally, it's been a win for the buyers themselves, the international buyers, who have realized the very important reputational gains of participating in this program. It's a win-win-win-win situation for all of the stakeholders.